Hello everybody, it's Nim, and welcome back to my channel. Merry Christmas! Today is Christmas Day, so Merry, Merry, Merry Christmas, and I hope that this Christmas will be good, and that you will have, if possible, contact with your family, be happy and merry, you know, and all the Christmas things. Christmas is like my favorite holiday, you probably already know that from the last videos that I uploaded this week. I love Christmas, and today, on Christmas Day, we are actually building a Christmas habitat for our Christmas reindeers. So we are making a habitat for Santa Claus's reindeers. And that's true, like they're real life Santa Claus reindeers. Except Rudolph, because Rudolph is obviously, you know, leading the sled of Santa because he's not here today, so, you know. We are starting off with building a Christmas themed home. Now, this Christmas themed, and I mean Christmas themed, like, it doesn't look very Christmassy yet. It will, don't worry, I promise that. We are going to color some of the walls. These are actually the ones from, I want to say, I believe those are aquatic. And aquatic, you can actually paint the color. And I love that. So we are going to make a red-green themed home with brick. And I absolutely love the way that it ends up. You probably saw it from the thumbnail and from the beginning cinematics. It will look amazing, and I'm totally biased because it's my own creation and I freaking love Christmas. Like, it's ridiculous how much I love Christmas. It's like, it's on a not healthy level anymore. But that's fine, you know, because Christmas is the best and I love Christmas. So, I got the idea, I don't want to say like I got inspired by something, I was just thinking, you know, for Christmas I need to do something special. And it took me so long to think of something that was special enough. I knew that I wanted to do something with the Arctic pieces, but I wasn't sure if I was going to do maybe a polar bear with Santa's village and then the polar bear can roam through that. Then I had the idea of the Nightmare Before Christmas, when you see the Christmas town, and I was like, wait, if I'm going to create a Christmas town, even though we are only creating one home because, you know, I know y'all are too busy to watch like a 45-minute video, so we're keeping it to one build. I didn't want to do polar bears, because I felt like that was maybe a bit of a cliché, and I know reindeers are even much more of a cliché, but I felt like reindeers would be way more realistic for a Santa build, for a Christmas build, so we are going with Santa's reindeers. And here we are just fixing the exterior first, we are placing down these glass windows, and this will be partly habitat, so like the shelter, but it will also be like the viewing point for the visitors. And how that is going to look, you will see that all when it comes together. And you will see me now detailing this home. Now, bear in mind, I have never ever built something in Planet Zoo that was this detailed. Except maybe the entrance of the Woodland Zoo. But anything else has never been this detailed as this home. Because, you know, I never built homes in Planet Zoo. I just built habitats with weird shelter things. Honestly, sometimes I don't get why people watch it, but don't stop watching it because I enjoy people watching my content. So I'm hoping that with this build, I have kind of reinvented myself in building, because now I know what I'm capable of. And that sounds really bad, but whenever, well, not whenever, but since I started playing Planet Coaster, I have come to the realization that there is so much more that I could be doing with pieces in Planet Zoo as well. So, from now on, our zoos are going to be way more detailed and probably very bad if you don't have a really good computer. But, you know, I have a very good computer and you can just watch the builds on my YouTube channel and watch them like that. So, this progress here is so tedious. I was inspired, you know, like I said, like Nightmare Before Christmas with the Santa Village, but also by Clark Griswold's Christmas home. And if you don't know who Clark Griswold is, he is played by Chevy Chase, and he's doing the movie A Christmas Vacation from the Griswolds. It's amazing, go Google it or something, because it's funny. I love that movie. I've watched that movie every Christmas since I was a kid, and I absolutely love it. And he has a Christmas home which is completely covered in lights, so I wanted to do like the little bit of lights all around the roof. Just, you know, here I go again, but detailing it. And I really think that I succeeded in it, and I'm actually really proud of it, the way it looks. We are going to add more lights, though. Like, it wasn't enough yet, so there's need to be more. We're also going to add some Christmas stars, but I'm getting ahead of myself because I am super excited You can probably hear that by the tone in my voice because, you know, oh, I'm so excited. I mean, look how cute it looks. All around the roof, it's just so cute. But there wasn't enough yet, so here we are adding more. And usually less is more, but in the terms of Christmas light, more is more. And that's honest to God true, more is more. So here we are making the entrance for the guests to go into, because I didn't want to have like an open piece in the wall, because I felt like that was pretty unrealistic. I mean, it's a Christmas zoo, so how realistic is it? But you know what I mean, you know. So I wanted to have it like pretty normal with normal doors, because you know, I went to a zoo before they were closed again because my country's again in lockdown, hurrah. And especially when you go into like the butterfly area, there are a lot of doors that you need to open. I was like, you know what, why not for a reindeer viewing point? Because it's going to be cold, this zoo is in the winter, it's somewhere snowy, it's cold, so you're gonna need that door to keep all the warmth inside. So there. Now this habitat is also in the workplace. Workshop. It's also in the workshop. The link to the workshop will be down in the description. Same as with my Instagram, Twitter, Twitch, Discord. Everything is down in the description. So make sure you check that out. And follow me on all the social medias, you know, because I am such an amazing content creator. You just need to follow me everywhere. I'm sorry, I can't even say that with a straight face. So here we are decorating our entire Christmas home. So I wanted it to be realistic again, so I went for doors. And now there is no actual way of you going upstairs, but that's completely fine. I mean, like, that's fine, it doesn't really matter. It's just there for show. I mean, oftentimes in zoo they have like big buildings, but usually half of the building is just for show. Oh, and here we are placing our Christmas stars. Oh. It's so magical. I mean, Christmas, I love it. In our home, we do Christmas presents each year, and it is so magical, and I have bought so many presents for my family. And at the moment that this video is uploaded, we are actually having a Christmas dinner with our family, and then we are, eating it and unpacking our presents. So, hooray! And I don't know how Christmas is for you guys this year, but, you know, in case you don't have anywhere to go and you can't go to your family and no one can come visit you, I hope that this video kind of gives you the feeling of being together with someone. And that's why I decided to upload it, even though it's Christmas. I still wanted people to feel loved and feel welcome. So bear that in mind. Like, if you're watching this, even if you're feeling lonely, comment down below. I will come back to you later this evening. Like, obviously right now I'm having my Christmas dinner, but once we're done, I am coming back to you and I'm wishing you a Merry Christmas. And if you need someone to talk, I'm here for you. Just vent it all out. That's completely fine. And, you know, maybe you are together with family and you're watching this later. I hope you had a very good Christmas, or maybe you watch this like a week from now or a year from now. Please tell me 2021 is better than 2020. I mean, comment down below if 2021 is better. If it's worse, comment that please too, then I know what I'm getting into. Yeah. Let's just hope that 2021 will be better. You know, we still have a week before it's New Year's, and I don't know for you guys, but New Year's is probably going to be another evening of staying inside and not doing anything. So, you know, luckily, I think New Year's... What day is New Year's? New Year's is also on a Friday, that's exactly in a week. So there will be another Planet Zoo video, so you can enjoy that. Okay, so let's go back to the video now, like I'm backtracking. You know, Planet Zoo and being so cool and chill about this. So here we are making my own Christmas tree, because I didn't like the Christmas trees in the game. Because I didn't feel like they were bright enough. I mean, look how bright this tree is. I love it. So we are placing that all around, because you know, you're gonna need a little bit of light in this dark time, in these dark times. You're gonna need light, you're gonna need, you know, cheer and excitement. So there we go. And we are gonna do a lot of rock work. I mean, we are just preparing it here right now. And I've said it again, and I will say it again. Like, I swear to you, the tundra and the taiga climate have the most stones ever. Together with the tropical ones. They're like, it's unfair according to like the temperate climate, that only has one stone. That's unfair. But whatever. And here we are just, you know, creating a little rock scenery, and these rocks will actually be our natural barrier, because I'm a great fan of natural barrier, as you people all know probably by now. I love the use of natural barrier, it feels very natural, which is kind of logical, but you know what I mean. And we are, in a moment, we're just going to copy and paste this all over the area. Now, this reindeer habitat, it used to be very big, and you saw me laying down the border. I checked at the screen and it was almost like 3,000 square meters. In the end, about half of that was gone because of the rocks. I believe that in the end we only had like 1,200 square meters left. And you can see me just placing these rocks very graciously, very spaciously as well. Just sticking them on top of each other, making an amazing natural border. And while I was actually working on this zoo, I was kind of imagining like, what if I were to continue this zoo and actually make it an actual zoo? Like sort of a winter zoo. That could be fun, but then I realized, you know what, once I realized that and you guys would like, oh yeah, this is cool, or like, please don't do that. Christmas will already have passed, so that is a nice idea for next year, but not for now. Assuming Planet Zoo still exists that year and, you know, we all still exist, because who knows what will happen. Ah, yes, the trees. Now, I'm a teacher, you'll know that. And I have been watching a video on Christmas trees with children. And apparently you have two types of trees. You have like den trees and pine trees. And pine trees are not Christmas trees, only dens are. So that was really fun actually, because now like I'm placing down these trees here in Planet Zoo, and I'm like, ah yes, this is a pine tree. So that is not a real Christmas tree. I even believe that I used a pine tree as my Christmas tree, but I'm not quite sure. Is that a den? Okay, I can't see it anymore because, you know, once I'm doing the voiceover, the entire screen gets a little bit blurry because it needs to render so much. But whatever, that's fine. Also, the space was seemingly getting smaller and smaller with each tree that I actually placed, because I'm such a big fan of trees, but reindeer apparently they can't walk directly near a tree, so it's gonna be a bit of a hassle. But that's all fine, we're all doing it for a good cause. Now, like I said before, like, this video is a bit shorter. Next week's video will be longer because, you know, it's New Year's. You don't have anything to do, so I guess I'm gonna make a very long video of our Red Tail Zoo. I was thinking of finally building with the aquatic pack. I was also thinking of maybe doing a live stream next week, but I'm not sure yet. If you have any thoughts on that, let me know in the comments down below, and I'll see if I can make that possible. Now, in a moment, we are going to put some enrichment items down, but because the reindeer doesn't really have a lot, like, they don't have a lot of items, so we are now just focusing on landscaping, and landscaping is my favorite. Y'all know that landscaping is my favorite thing to do in this game. That's actually in every game except Planet Coaster is still a bit tricky because they have so many color options, but I will get the hang of that, don't worry. Ah yes, in a minute we are going to do the inside of the viewing point. Actually, I keep calling it viewing points, they're viewing habitats, I don't know what to call it. Now I'm lost for words. Oh well. We are going to decorate this. I initially thought I was going to keep it pretty mellow and cool. And I was like, no, I'm going all out because it's Christmas. So we are making a starry sky. Wow. Okay, that word did not come out of my mouth. I'm sorry. I felt like I completely stuttered on that word. Whoops. You know, and I just feel like the stars, it's magical, I love stars. And we are going to place a little bit of more light down at the home, because, you know, it was pretty dark, and I still want this habitat to look good when it's actually dark. And I feel like in the end it actually looks good, but you will see that in the cinematics. Ooh, wait, the cinematics are already here. What? Okay, well, then I'm going to leave you guys with the cinematics, and I hope you have a wonderful Christmas. I will say it again, Merry Christmas, and I will see you guys next week. Bye, guys.